You've probably heard of SSMA for migrating from non-SQL objects to SQL Server or Azure SQL. In this episode, learn with me as we dive into the tool. This week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Alexandra, a program manager on the Azure SQL team focusing on migrations. Alexandra, thanks for joining us today. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Sure, Anna. Thanks for having me. My name is Alexandra Saigorta, and I'm a program manager in Azure SQL team focused on heterogeneous migration and helping customers move their databases from other relational products to Azure SQL or SQL on-prem.
Thanks, awesome. We are happy to have you here. And today we're gonna be talking about migrations, like I mentioned, but you work in the heterogeneous space. So that's moving from non-SQL Server to SQL Server and Azure SQL. And I'm really interested to understand, like, what are some of the challenges that people face when they try to do this, and how do they address them?
Customers usually are challenged on the data migration, schema conversion, and post-migration validation task. And that's a really coherent challenge that we see across our customers. In order to address these issues, we recommend using SQL Server Migration Assistant, a suite of five tools targeting migrations coming from DB2, Access, Sybase ASE, Oracle, and MySQL to SQL Server or Azure SQL DB. So we try to automate as much as possible from the migration journey and make it easy for our customers.
Awesome, cool. And you know, I've heard a lot about this tool, SSMA, some people call it. I'm sure you guys call it that all the time. But I'd love to understand a little bit more, like, how do I use it? How does it work? Like, can I see it in action? That sort of thing.
Sure. Let me walk you through the migration journey, and I'm going to share my screen. In order to start a migration project, the first thing you need to do is basically initialize that project in SSMA. So I'm going to create a project, call it live demo. Why not? And I'm going to choose a migration to Azure SQL database. It usually takes a few seconds for the project to be initialized. And the next natural step is to connect to your source. In this demo, I'm going to use an Oracle 11.2 version. And I'm just going to provide the password for that environment. When it comes to a connectivity to Oracle, we support different drivers: Oracle Data Provider for .NET, OLIDB Provider, and ODBC Driver. The connection modes we support are Standard Mode, TNS Name Mode, and also Connection String Mode if you want to build the connection string yourself. Once you have initialized your connection to Oracle Server, we discover the Oracle version and also load the user schema available. For today's demo, we are going to go with the classical HR schema, and we are going to load that for our conversion. The load time for user schema depends on the complexity and number of objects that you have in your environment, and it also depends on the version of Oracle you use as a source.
Cool. So right now in the background, it's kind of analyzing that schema.
Exactly. It's analyzing the system views from Oracle, and we are using queries to retrieve the information. That is going to help us build a local metabase in SSMA and reproduce the structure of the objects that you have in your Oracle source.
Awesome.
And now it's done. I can see my Oracle server, and I can also have a look at the schemas that I've basically discovered. The one that I would like to convert is called HR schema. The next step in the conversion process would be to create a conversion report. The report itself doesn't do the conversion on your target, it's just parsing and converting objects to be able to offer some statistics regarding the conversion ratio and possible issue that you may see. For each and every object available in the metabase, we are going to create an HTML file, and we'll be able to render that, even use it later on if you'd like to review it. And this is the time it takes to generate the report. Once the conversion report is generated, you can navigate through the schema objects. The level of information we show is different depending on the object that you are looking at. At the schema level, we are looking at total conversion ratio, which was 100%. And then we'll also have some statistics regarding the object type and how many objects we converted successfully and how many objects reported errors. In the lower part of the pane, we have three sections: errors, warnings, and information. Errors usually cover migration issues that we couldn't automatically fix in SSMA and that you would need to manually address. In the warning section, we have objects or data types that we were able to automatically convert that may behave actually different in SQL Server. An example from that space is the number data type. We don't have a corresponding data type in SQL Server for a direct mapping, so we have converted that to float. In the pane, for procedures and object containing TSQL code, you can also have a side-by-side comparison. This will give you an overview of the possible migration issues that you may encounter. Once you are happy reviewing the report, you can proceed with the schema conversion. Generating the report is not a prerequisite to convert the schema, but it's something that you can generate without connecting to your target. The next step for me is to connect to my Azure SQL database to be able to convert the schema. So I'm just going input the password for that. Hopefully I'll get it right. Okay. And now I'm loading the objects from my Azure SQL database inside my local metabase in the tool. The database that we are going to use today is an empty Azure SQL database called HRDB. So here I don't have any other schemas except the default schemas. At this point in time, we are going to convert the schema. And the difference between this action and the previous action is that all that converted code is going to be inserted in the target metabase. So if I'm just going to expand here, you see I have a new entry. It's the HR schema. And for this HR schema, I'll have the tables and the stored procedures from my Oracle source. In the lower pane, we have an overview, and we're going to walk you through the warnings, information messages. If you want to uncheck information messages and just review the warnings, you can do that. Another cool feature of SSMA is the fact that you can compare the original PSQL and the translated TSQL code. There are a lot of things that you can set in terms of conversion and the type mapping. You can do column style mapping, local variable step mapping, and we have a lot of other options at the project level as well. So please explore all these type mappings and customize it for your own migration. You can make changes to your schema. You can even add objects if you want here, change the script. And after you are done and happy with the final version, you are ready to move the data. But even before moving the data, we need to synchronize the local metabase with our Azure SQL database target. So in order to do this, I'm just going to use the synchronize to database. And then I'll have a comparison also here in terms of the object differences between these two, my local metadata and my target, which is my Azure SQL DB. And I don't have any tables here at this point, so I'm just going to deploy all my converted objects to Azure SQL DB. So I'm just going to click OK.
So it's kind of a two-step process. You convert, and then when you're happy with the conversion that happened, then you can basically choose to deploy. So once you convert, you're not automatically deploying. Am I getting that right?
Yes, you are. That's right. So once you convert, you basically convert your local Oracle objects to your SQL local objects, SQL local metadata. Both of these are metadata. And I think that's a very good point, Anna, because you can work with these projects in offline mode as well. So once you have loaded the meta information within the tool, you can save the project, open it later on, and work on creating conversion reports or work on converting the schemas. So you don't have to be connected to your source and target all the time. We just need this local meta information. We call them metabases.
Cool.
And now we're just waiting for the deployment to finish to our Azure SQL DB. Now that everything has been deployed, we're just going to check it in SSMS and make sure the tables are there. So I am connected to my Azure SQL DB, HR DB, and I'm going to expand the table section. We can find here the tables coming from Oracle, originated in Oracle. Now let's see if there is something in this table. So remember guys, we just did schema conversion. So right now, if we are going to do a select on this table, the output is empty because we did not migrate the data yet. So what options do we have for the data migration? So we can initialize the data migration from within SSMA. We can run a server-side data migration using stored procedures and SQL agent to connect directly to Oracle and pull the data into SQL Server. Or we can use Azure Data Factory. We can leverage the copy activity that will allow for automatic partitioning and configure the batch write size on SQL Server side. For today's demo, we are going to walk through the data movement from SSMA. So we've already converted the schema. Now we are going to migrate the data. In order to migrate the data, you'd need to connect to your source and target system. So let's see if I had that correctly typed. Okay. Now we are all connected. We are preparing the table for the actual migration, starting the migration engine, and at the end, we're going to have like a nice report that we can share with you. In this report, you can review the total number of rows, how many were successfully migrated, and the duration for each and every activity. Now let's go back to Management Studio, and let's rerun this query. Yay, we have the Oracle data migrated within SQL Server and ready for you to use. Another great feature of SSMA is actually the possibility to test and validate migrated objects. But for this feature, stay tuned for the next episode.
Awesome. Okay. Thanks so much, Alexandra. This has been really useful. You know, I just had one follow-up question. You showed how we can basically convert everything, our schema, our objects, even migrate our data. But what if I have like some ad hoc SQL or Oracle, in this case, queries? Can I convert those queries as well? Or is that kind of what the tester you just mentioned is for? Or
sure, we can convert. We can definitely convert statements as well. We have here a statements node which you can use to add your statement. You can type your statement or you can use SSMA in console mode to load the statements from .sql file, and we will be able to convert them as well.
Oh, that's pretty cool. So I can basically like import all the ad hoc queries I do kind of on a regular basis, and you guys will help me figure out what those should be in SQL.
Definitely. Awesome. Whatever we've done for the stored code, we will also do in terms of conversion and reports for the ad hoc statements as well.
Awesome. Great. Well, thanks so much, Alexandra. This has been really insightful for me. As someone who had never seen SSMA before, I'm super impressed with all the capabilities that are built into this, and I'm really looking forward to getting hands-on. We will provide some links in the description so you guys can learn more about SSMA. And Alexandra gave us a little teaser. In the next episode, we're actually going to be covering this tester that you can use after you've migrated your objects and your data. So stay tuned. Thanks for joining us. If you like this episode, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, leave us a comment, and let us know what you're doing with SSMA. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.